Father Pope Francis and the Ordinary of the Roman Catholic Diocese of Cubao, His Excellency, Pope's Reverend Bishop Ernesto Jovo. And today is also the 5th anniversary of our Masses here at the National Chapel. So this is the National Latin Mass we're recording to open at 16 the next of Grand Forum of Roman Rite. This test and certify explaining what the Ordinary Forum is. Is the form of the Mass born taught or set by 8,000 domestic viewers since the 30th of November 1969 up to this day. So, the exorbitant form is the form of the memory of the Council that is from the year 1519 under Pope St. Benedict the Great until Blessed Pope Paul VI, to be canonized in Paul VI, 1879 years ago. So, our for this month, Cathechisis is all about the communion of the Lord. A celebrated saying of St. Augustine, cited by Pope Benedict XVI in his encyclical Sacramentum Caritatis, teaches, no one eats that flesh without first adoring. We should simply, were we not to adore. Meaning indicates and promotes adoration necessary for receiving the Eucharistic Christ. And for this reason, the congregation of divine worship and the discipline of sacraments on July 1st of 2002 maintained that the practice of kneeling for Holy Communion has in its favor a centuries-old tradition, and it is a particularly expressive sign of adoration, completely appropriate in light of the true, real, and substantial presence of our Lord Jesus Christ under the consecrated species. And we observe some parishes in the archipelago, especially in dioceses, in some of the dioceses in Quezon, these parishes will enforce the communion, receiving communion on the tongue, aside from the usual receiving the communion by the hand, especially some of the cathedrals in Quezon. So there's nothing wrong with this kind of tradition. It's actually the real tradition receiving of the Lord, our Eucharistic Christ, the form of prayer. So to end this catechesis, may I then ask the faithful to join us in praying today's Mass, the 5th anniversary of this national shrine, and to remember in our prayers the Dominican community of Santo Domingo, led by the very Reverend Father Roda Pope, because it is only through their generosity that our monthly traditional Latin Mass is made possible. Second, we ask the more generous in the collection of this Mass because our contribution helps the Dominican community in their ministry of spreading the good news to the least, the last, and the most. Also, we ask the pray for the Societas Iglesia de Santo Joseph, una voce in Salado, Filipinado, Iglesia de Society of St. Joseph, led by the Reverend Father Mitchell Joseph. Together with the other Latin Mass societies in the country, notably the Latin Mass Society of St. Ferdinand, it is only through our prayers and support that we are able to continue the ministry of promoting the sense of Messiah. Announcements. We have distributed messages for the faithful to make the congregation in their applause of participation or actual prayer consecration. And also, this final schedule of the Mission Latin Masses at Most Holy Redeemer Parish, of the Mission Believing Schedule of Communities at the back of the Mission. So let us now spend a few moments of silence, prayer, and